Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Happy Tuesday. Happy Wednesday, if you're watching this in Universal whatever, UTC time. Happy future if you're watching this in the future. Happy past if you're watching this in the past. If you have one of those time TVs that I've heard so much about. I'm going to be playing Spelunky Death Roulette, which is a cool audience participation thing that someone came up with for Spelunky. Hello, CPC Gamer in the chat room. Not sure if you're playing Death Roulette or not, or if anyone is, but I'm going to go ahead and start the round here. Let me know if I have the music up too loud. I tested the volume levels, and it sounded okay to me, but... you know, I can never tell. So, basically what's going to happen is I'm going to bet 10 units of fake currency on succeeding at Spelunky. I'm basically betting on myself to win. And you're all going to bet on how I die. And there are, options for every enemy in the game, every trap, different types of accidents I can succumb to. Or you can bet on me to win. Under successes down at the bottom, and bets are going to be open until I die, at which point I will lock the bets, and since there's a delay on Twitch, that shouldn't be a problem for, you know, potential cheating. But to start out, I'm just going to bet 10 on myself. I don't know if you can see, but I have 441. Everyone starts out. Oh, you're Spelunky Bucks. Everyone starts out with 500, but I was messing around betting on someone else's stream the other day, so I lost a little bit. So, let's go. Let's go ahead and start the round. Got $10 riding on my, eventual success. Sounds like Salty Bet, which incidentally is just where I came from. Yes, it is very much like Salty Bet, except that you are betting on my incompetence rather than, artificial intelligence versus artificial intelligence. Salty Bet is way too addictive. I had to stop myself from going to that site because I was just spending too much time sitting there watching fake fights. Okay, so let's get started. I already did, the daily challenge, I guess, it just reset. So that's open. But I'm going to do a few adventures. I unlocked a new character, the Lady Pirate, which is very exciting. This is probably going to become one of my standard default characters. The music is None of This is Real by DJ Roswell. It is an album that I discovered on Bandcamp. And it describes itself, or he describes the album, as a hip-hop roguelike album, which I thought was really interesting, and I thought it would be cool to mix things up a little and play it during the stream. The instructions that he gives for listening to the album are to play it on shuffle. There's about 40 some tracks, and it's about an hour long, and he says to play it on shuffle and to, well, he or she, I guess, could be either one. Says to play it on shuffle and have a crossfade of about 6 seconds between the tracks, so they all, you know, blend together very smoothly, which is how I'm playing it. I was a little bit hesitant to play music during the stream because I'm afraid of copyright strikes when I put it up on YouTube. But well, A, DJ Roswell's giving away the album for free. You can get it at the Bandcamp URL that I have on the stream there. And B, I don't think DJ Roswell is really associated with a label or anything, so hopefully that'll prevent me from getting copyright strikes, you know, from him or her. The only thing that I might run into a problem with is, I mean, I'm sure there are tons of samples on this album. Sort of more of a mixtape than an album, I guess. You know, it's sort of half mashup, half remix. You know, just a lot of cool stuff kind of mixed together. So hopefully I don't get any copyright strikes from unclear samples. But you know, oh, I love this track. A person can't live his life in fear from Google's copyright goons. There comes a time in a man's life when he has to make a stand for what's right. And I'm starting to think that time is now. I don't know. With the way Google's been behaving recently, just going crazy with the copyright strikes on YouTube, starting to think it's time to distance myself from YouTube a little bit. I don't know. I mean, there are other ways I can get the videos to you guys. I mean, they're archived on Twitch, for one. And that's not 100% reliable, because I don't know how long those will actually be kept or, you know, stored on Twitch's servers. But I can always... Well, I have 15 gigabytes of Google Drive space, which I guess is what everyone has. And that'll be enough to archive the last few videos, or the last few months' worth of videos, since a 2-hour Spelunky video is a little over a gig. So, you know, the last 14 or 15 Spelunky videos I could host there, no problem. The problem with that is, you know, I'm still relying on Google. So even though they don't have the content ID match for videos you upload to Google Drive, at least I don't think they do, you know, I'm still kind of part of Google's ecosystem. So that might, I don't know. I mean, it might work out okay. Content ID might not be a problem, but, you know, I kind of like to get away from Google entirely if possible. I mean, it's not possible because, you know, I rely on Gmail for everything, and my domain email is hosted through Google Apps. So there's no way around that. But you know, there has to be a better solution than living in fear of Content ID all the time. I could use Dropbox. It's $9.99 a month, and you get like 100 gigs or so, which should be plenty to store like a year's worth of videos. And then for the archives, I can just like make a torrent or something. Oh. For some reason, I thought I already triggered that that arrow trap. Oh well. I used a DJ Roswell track in an LP I had going once. It was a remix of the Tank theme. Oh, that's awesome. Yeah, I literally never heard of this guy until the other day. I was looking at the West Virginia tag on Bandcamp, and apparently this person's from West Virginia? I don't know. I can't really find any information. Oh god, fuck! That was a dumb death. Okay, well, let's see if, looks like CPC Gamer voted on Spikes, which ended up being a smart bet. It's always a smart bet, actually. Spikes are prominent throughout the entire game. That's a good way to go. Alright, let's start another one. Okay, well, that was a good warm-up. Let's go again. So yeah, if I do upload this to YouTube and it ends up getting, you know, taken down, or I get my account locked or whatever, you know, it's not the end of the world. I'll figure out a way to get the videos to everyone. I'd say getting my account outright banned would probably be the worst. Because then I couldn't even, like, post videos telling people what happened and where to find the videos on whatever my new hosting solution is. McGack2 says, Spikes, are they in the ice cavern? I think so. I don't know. Now that you mention it, I'm not sure if they are. But, you know, they're everywhere else, definitely. Oh, Jesus. Oh, wow, two crates in there. That's pretty good. They're prominent in the mines and the jungle, anyway, which is where the bulk of my playing is going to be spent. I guess they might not be in the ice caverns. I don't know. I never really thought about it. Today, I tilted with the Black Knight from a far land and unseated him roundly. Oops, sorry. With lances blown. Feet worthy of horses. Why not take the threat? Because I was sneakily attacked by his ally and soon came up in the middle of my sunlight. A lot of movie quotes and stuff on this album, too. The album is called None of This Is Real. If you want to get the exact set of tracks that I'm listening to. You can also buy a tape of the album for $5, which I ordered the other day. Has not arrived yet, obviously. I don't have a tape player, so I don't know what I'm going to do with it. But I was going to give them $5 for the album anyway. And I figured, hey, if I want to spend $5, might as well get a tape out of it. So yeah, I don't know where this guy's from. His the thing was tagged West Virginia, so he might be from West Virginia, or he might be affiliated with the state somehow. I don't know. So I mentioned I'll be using some new strats in today's stream. Strat is short for strategy, as frequently used by pro gamers like myself. You know, I might as well go on ahead and buy that paste. I might not encounter a spider. So, the strategy I've been going with lately has been spending money up until you get to the black market, buying as many bombs as possible, obviously, and then any other useful items you might come across. And once you get to the black market, kill all the shopkeepers and steal everything. Which I've been hesitant to do that in the past, but I have gotten comfortable with... Oh, fuck. I've gotten comfortable with doing a run with angry shopkeepers. The strategy that I saw in another person's stream is in the black market, you want to bomb out the left side of the area. And then once you anger the shopkeepers, they all kind of run out and fall down that shaft on the left-hand side. And you put a rope down so you can climb up and avoid them. And ideally, they all kind of get jumbled together down at the bottom of the level. And usually, they'll take each other out. At least, they'll take a lot of themselves out. And that's how I got the kill the 12 shopkeepers achievement, which I thought I never would. For fuck's sake. But I've had a certain degree of success with that strategy, so that is what I'm going to try if I don't repeatedly die in the mines in incredibly stupid ways. Geez, I'm gonna have to use a bomb and a rope to get that dog, but it's worth it. Because I only have one health. So yeah, that's the strategy that I'll be going with. And I got to hell the other day, just playing. Not streaming, obviously. But I made it to hell, and I had the best daily challenge run I ever had using that strategy. And making it to the City of Gold. I ended up with 360,000. Which didn't put me in the top 100, but I was pretty close. I was like number 160 something. Yeah, I hear ya. Oh, it's pausing when I click over to the chat room to see if anyone else has showed up. I'm using the web interface instead of the normal IRC chat room just because I don't know. I couldn't be bothered to load my client up. Aw, man. Well, I guess I have all these bombs. I might as well just, might as well use them. Of course, that did not trigger the arrow trap. Tried to make that jump, but I could not. Paradox Zero, wow. Oh, hey, Paradox Zero, what's up? He had a lot of faith in me. He bet on several enemies in the caves. Wait, did I lock the bets? Well, I guess not. And CPC Gamer bet on accidents or long fall. So, no winners that time, unfortunately. Alright, let's start a new round. Man, I'm just playing like absolute shit. I was hoping to maybe get a few new viewers from the Spelunky Death Roulette website, because they feature streams on the front page. I'm not sure if mine's going to be featured there. Probably not, because I don't have that many viewers, but there were some streams with relatively low numbers of viewers featured, so I guess it's possible. But I was watching a stream the other day by a guy named Shirtless something or other. I forget the it was like Shirtless Joe or Shirtless Mike or something like that. I don't know. Or just, maybe we're just Shirtless Guy. But that's how I discovered the Spelunky Death Roulette. Hello, Lunchbot in the chat room. I'm not sure, oh, if you want to if you want the link to the Death Roulette, just go to dukeofthebump.com/bet. It's the URL on the screen there. And I'm not sure what chat command you were trying to do, but I'm pretty sure it does not work with my current setup. So yeah, I've had some sloppy runs. Let's try to move my game up.
But what began as a party quickly turned into a nightmare.
Oh god. Fuck. For some reason, I thought the arrow trap was down there, which is why I threw that pot down. But, my peripheral vision failed me. So yeah, I've been playing pretty much nothing but this recently. I am almost done with Super Mario 3D Land on the 3DS. I went to the laundromat the other day, and I'm actually on the last level. I did not beat the last level before I was done at the. Oh fuck! What am I doing? I didn't want to go looking for the key because I was feeling lazy. Oh well. So, my new philosophy with streaming is, because of the bets, and just because it's more entertaining, I'm not going to kill myself and start over, like, even if it looks like I'm having a bad run. Like, if I take a lot of damage on level 1, I'm not going to restart, because, really, any run could potentially end in an Olmec kill. Like, no matter how poorly I do at the beginning, I can always come back. And that's kind of the, that's kind of more the philosophy I'm going with lately. So, I'm never going to, restart. No matter how poorly I do. Oh, is this song one of those songs used in Salty Bet? Oh, it's probably the original version, though. The Sippin' on Syrup by, I'm not sure who it's by. Yeah, Salty Bet is super, super fun. If anyone watching has never experienced it, basically somebody set up a Mugen multi-fighting game software with just billions and billions of characters, and it's always running with the AI fighting itself. And I think it's just saltybet.com, and you can bet on which AI you think is going to win. And like I said, it's super addictive. Like, there was a while there where I was just watching that for just like a couple hours a day, and I was like, wow, I have to stop this, because this is draining all of my productivity. Not that I'm productive, but you know, I tell myself I'm productive to make me feel better about myself. One spot says, I made it. You made it to the end of Spelunky? Because that's what it says when you kill Olmec. Well, no, that's what it says when you get to the City of Gold, actually. It says, I made it. Or maybe it's, I finally made it. So yeah, there's still a chance I'll make it to the black market, even though I don't have the eye, which apparently is pronounced the Watchet Eye. That's how I heard someone say it in a stream. But if I'm lucky enough to see the entrance to the black market without the eye, then which has happened a few times, then I might still have a chance at doing a hell run. I'd really like to make it to hell during this stream. Beating hell is, of course, out of the question. Oh, you made it to the roulette. Cool. But, yeah. But if I can't make it to hell, no big deal. I can always go for another Olmec win. Olmec kill. I have 4 Olmec kills. Well, technically, I have 6 Olmec kills. Only 4 of them count as wins, because those are times I killed Olmec and I actually went to the exit. There was the one time I went to hell, which was the other day, and the one time I killed Olmec, but I died trying to make it to hell. Which, I was pretty pissed off about that, because I didn't realize that, that you could not just go in the door to hell. You have to actually ride Olmec long enough to you have to stand on him long enough to walk into the door, because there's no platform there. Excuse me. Hello, Lord Tamar in the chat room. How's it going? Yeah, I can't see the bets until I actually switch over to that window after I die. So, I'm not going to lock the bets until I actually die. So, one strategy you might employ is to wait to bet and see how far I actually make it in the game before you place the bet. Or see how well I'm doing. Because it would suck if you can bet up to 50 Spelunky bucks, and you can spread your bet across up to 5 different ends. And you know, it would suck to bet all of your to use all of your slots on stuff in the mines, stuff that's, you know, predominantly or only in the mines, and then I make it past that. So you might want to hold your bets. But on the other hand, you know, if you wait too long, I might die suddenly and lock the bets before you have a chance to bet. So, oh god. Oh god. Fucking piranhas. That's a That's probably another good bet. That thing activated because I accidentally hit the idol with my whip. Even though I didn't pick it up. Yeah, there's nothing up there. Oh god. I don't even know why I went for the damn idol. For fuck's sake, man. Well, that's one way to kill a piranha. I meant to just throw the bomb to the bottom of that thing and drain all the water, but I will take that. Okay, speaking of roulette. Freeze ray, no, thank you. If you are an inventor, like a mad scientist type, like a Dr. Venture, and your assistant is named Ray, you should probably be careful talking about your freeze ray around him. Because he might think you're pointing a gun at him. That was a dumb joke. I probably could have done that more elegantly. But it still would have been a dumb joke either way. Well, so much for spotting the black market. Jeez. I've noticed how quickly a good run can be ruined by a dark level. It's kind of my biggest nemesis at the moment. I would say let me know if you see the black market, but, depending on how you bet, that might be against your best interests. Need to lure that frog away from the altar. There we go. See if we can get the springy boots out of this. Nope. Oh, yeah, there it is. Cool. Yeah, this album is mostly instrumental hip-hop, but there are a few traditional rap songs on it, which, you know, I'm not too worried if there are people who don't like it, because, you know, it's my stream, etc. But, you know, just a heads up. Anything good for sale down there? Oh yeah, there's some good stuff. I guess since I'm not going to the black market, I won't bother angering the shopkeepers. I mean, it's worth it in the black market because you can get a ton of awesome stuff for free. But otherwise, Matic, eh? Well, fuck. That was close. I almost died to bat, which would have been embarrassing. I'm about to die to frog too. Jesus. Get me the hell out of here. I like rap and hip-hop. It surprises a lot of people. Yeah, me too. I didn't used to like it, but I kind of learned to appreciate it. The problem was, the only rap I was exposed to was like the stuff they were playing on the radio in the late 90s. Like, that was my main source of hip-hop exposure, and I mean, there's some good stuff back then, but overall it was not the best crop of hip-hop available. Whoa, I never saw the shotgun, like, well, I guess it's nothing special. It's weird to see just a small little outcropping like that with the ash tombstone. What level is this, 2-4? Okay. I was going to say I could go to a secret level, but I don't think that exit will exist in this level, since it is 2-4. If you see a tombstone with a crown under it, and you bomb or dig under that tombstone, there's a there's a secret level you can get to, which I've gotten to once, and it's pretty cool. I'll try to go there at some point during the stream. Wasn't radio rap in the 90s kind of early Eminem and Limp Bizkit? Well, Limp Bizkit is a whole other pile of shit. That's new metal, which is bad. But I like Eminem's first two major albums, the Slim Shady and Marshall Mathers LPs. Hey, what's up, Kasia? But it was a lot of like, oh God. I don't know. I mean, I was gonna say it's a lot of like Outkast and stuff, but there's Outkast that I like now. Actually, now that I think of it, there's a lot of music from that era that I didn't used to like that I like now. I guess it's more like it's more that I gained an appreciation for it. But yeah, Limp Bizkit, I used to listen to them, and it's one of the things I'm ashamed of, because Limp Bizkit have always been and will always be bad. Them and Korn, ugh. Like, that's probably the most embarrassing thing about the 90s, looking back on it. But yeah, Eminem's first two albums, solid. His albums after that, the singles never really appealed to me, so I never checked them out as much as I could. Yeah, oh God, I hope that doesn't piss him off. Okay, good. I mean, not that it would be a huge deal, but it's better not to deal with them if you don't have to. Oh God. I might still have a shot at Olmec. I wish I had way more bombs than I do, but it's going better than I thought it would based on my early performances. A lot of the stuff I used to instinctively hate was because of my parents' attitude towards swearing. Oh man, I don't like that because swearing is bad, but then you listen to Stan and it's like, oh damn. Yeah, my parents always objected to some of the music I listened to. But you know, before rap, I listened to a lot of old metal and stuff, and that was not the cleanest music in the world, like Anthrax. I really like how this track starts out. I almost deleted it from the playlist, but it gets better in short order. Uh-oh. Well, sorry, dog. I have to admit, it is kind of nice not to have to deal with the shopkeepers. Like, I've dealt with them on most of my recent playthroughs. What old Limp Bizkit kicks ass? Shut up, Duke. Well, we'll have to agree to disagree. I don't know. I guess some of the tracks on $3 Bill, y'all, are still listenable. It's not my first choice of music, but it's better than Linkin Park anyway. God, that's another one of those 90s new metal bands. Crawling in my skin. These wounds, they will not heal. I'm going mammoth hunting. I should really hold on to my bombs. God, what's with every single damsel being stuck inside somewhere this game? Like, every time I want to rescue a damsel, it's like, oh, hope you have a bomb. Which, I mean, I do, but I'd really like to hold on to them. I'm going to try to kill Olmec on this run. And then the two genres collided with Anthrax, Public Enemies, Bring the Noise. Yeah, that was actually a little bit before my time, I think. Although I do remember that track being in Tony Hawk Pro Skater 2. That's where I was exposed to it primarily. Yeah, that was kind of the genesis of the whole rap rock fusion thing, was Bring the Noise. Oh god. Oh fuck. Okay, well, that guy, oh crap, there's a jetpack in there. I probably would have pissed that guy off anyway to get the jetpack. I did not realize that until just now. Nice. Well, that should make Olmec a bit easier to deal with. We do have pissed off shopkeepers, but I've gotten used to them. But yeah, Anthrax, Public Enemy's Bring the Noise was a pretty cool track. I think it was because, you know, it was Public Enemy doing the rapping. It wasn't, you know, Fred Durst or somebody who's not as good at rapping. I love this track. It's like the, it's like something you'd hear in like the old animated Hobbit movie, like just the cheesiest fantasy, you know, cheese you can imagine, mashed up with I think 50 Cent. Is that who's rapping on this? I don't know. My knowledge of hip hop artists is tragically insufficient. Well, I could grab that scepter, but I'm not in a suicidal mood tonight. Oof. Speaking of not in a suicidal mood, I'll deal with that before it becomes a problem. Crap. I don't really want to go this way anyway. Well, I guess I do have to go that way. Jesus! Confuse all my bombs just dealing with these things. Oh man, this sucks. I think I'll go this way. As much as I'd like to get to that crate down there, I'll settle for getting this crate up here. I guess I could use another bomb. Yeah, why not? This is not a very user-friendly level layout. Okay, that trap has already been sprung, so I should be safe. Oh yeah, that guy. he took care of himself. Is that the one with the theme tune by Leonard Nimoy? Oh yeah. The Ballad of Bilbo Baggins. I don't think it was that song, but that's definitely the right track. Have I seen the Russian animated Hobbit movie? You know, I think I saw that on YouTube once. Quite a long time ago. That was something else. Russian animation is always a little trippy, but when it's something you're familiar with, like source material you're familiar with, it's even weirder. Alright, should be safe from the zero trap. Yeah. God, it's a discount trap warehouse in here. Alright, let's go this way. Yeah, this should be good. Hate to use another bomb, but it's better than trying to navigate those traps. And that crate might be bombs. I better risk it. Of course, since I had the jetpack, it would be easy for me to fly up and get all the boxes that are in Olmec's lair. So, hopefully, Jesus. I wish the shopkeeper would trigger that thwomp trap. That'd be pretty nice. Alright, let's go this way, I guess. Deathstalker and the Warriors from Hell. That sounds familiar. That's one of those, isn't that one of those movies that MST3K did? I think they did that at some point. Oh god. If not, then, oh, Jesus Christ! No! Alright, who put money on Shopkeeper? One spot, congratulations. Sorry to everyone else. One spot is the victor on that one. Russian Winnie the Pooh, yeah, that too. Alright, well, I feel better about that run than previous runs. I made it a pretty good distance there. And a pretty good ending score as well. Oh, that's a good way to start a run. Nothing over there. I know that one of the Eastern European countries calls him Mickey Mako. Is that what they call the Hobbit in Russia? Because I think Winnie the Pooh is just called like Vinnie Pooh or something. Like V-I-N-I-E-P-U-H. At least I believe that's what Russian Winnie the Pooh is called. What happens when you run out of money? Well, if it's anything like Salty Bet, you can just fill back up to 500. Like 500 is the minimum. Well, I don't know what the minimum amount is on Salty Bet, but that's how Salty Bet operates. It has a minimum amount of cash that you can have. They might make you wait a certain amount of time before they refill your money or something along those lines. Or, you know, you could just be good and never have to find out. Ooh, teleporter. I'll give you a professional betting tip for my streams. Never bet on teleporter, because I'm not going to use the teleporter. I'm not that dumb. Crap. Oh well. I was trying to bounce on a spider and get up and break that pot, but it's not that important. From the look of it, it's Hungarian. The Hungarian Winnie the Pooh is called Mickey Mako. Oh, pronounced like Missy Mashko. Huh. Well, there's your Hungarian fact of the day. Oh, and Kostya said I'm correct that Winnie the Pooh is called Vinnie Pooh in Russia. Dang, that's a lot of good swag in the item shop. I guess I'll buy gloves since I don't have enough for the bombs. Gloves are probably the smart move anyway. Because there will be plenty of opportunities to get more bombs, especially if I can go to the black market. Speaking of black market, I'm going to have to use two bombs to get to that key. That kind of irritates me. Yeah, I hope DJ Roswell does more of these. roguelike mixtapes. So it's a really cool concept. It's like a little bit different every time you listen to it. I'm not sure what the order of tracks is going to be on the actual cassette tape. Not that I'll probably be able to listen to it. I guess I'll have to get a tape player. Just to make sure that there are no secret messages to me on the tape or anything. Oh, fuck. I should probably rescue that dog, seeing as how I'm down to 2 health. Pisses me off. Stupid dog. Why couldn't you be down at ground level? How the hell did you get up there in the first place? Dogs can't climb ropes. Oh. Let's see. Sorry, Poncho. I think I'm okay not gambling money to get a teleporter. Oh man, speaking of teleporter, well, sort of, I read a fact about the Binding of Isaac remake that's supposed to come out sometime this year, and I have to say it got me pretty excited. I think that remake might actually get me to play the Binding of Isaac again, despite the fact that I already have 200 hours in the existing version of the game. And I've done everything you can possibly do in that game. Because it sounds like they're actually adding a lot to it. Like, they're adding an amount of content. I think the fact said equivalent to the amount of... equivalent to the amount of content in The Wrath of the Lamb. Now, with the betting thing, everyone wants Duke to die. Well, you know I'm going to die. That's inevitable. But, you know... Now you can benefit from my death. Because, I mean, you know, look at the odds. I've only beaten Olmec once during a stream. So, chances are pretty good. Oh, Lord. Chances are pretty good that I'm not actually going to succeed. But, hey, if you do bet on me to win... and I actually do win, then I would be very, very grateful for your confidence in me. And I will reward you with a special shout out, I guess. I don't know. That's not a very optimistic attitude, dude. Well, that's kind of the attitude you have to go into games like this. I mean, any game with, like, a roguelike mentality, you know, you kind of have to accept death. Because if you don't accept death, then you're going to get frustrated and quit. Alright, that trap has been triggered. Holy shit, this track is banging. I'm just going to be quiet and listen to this. I want to go for this damsel, but I'm running low on bombs. But, you know, that's a nice thing about an angry shopkeeper run, is I don't have to worry. Well, I do have to worry about having enough bombs to get to the black market. That is one concern. But if I do run into a shopkeeper selling bombs, I can actually buy them and not have to worry about saving my money. I'm waiting for Isaac on XBLA. Still waiting on Hotline Miami too. I think the Binding of Isaac remake is only announced for PC, PlayStation 4, and Vita at this point. But the fact did say that new consoles are a possibility. Alright. Well, the black market is in this level, and I don't have any bombs. And he's not selling any bombs. Great. F my luck. And the bees. Which, you know, the bees normally wouldn't be a problem. But I don't have any bombs to deal with the queen bee. I want to put a rope here to assist in the murdering of bees. Alright. Let's lure the little bees up, and maybe... because the queen bee is going to be stuck there. She's not going to be able to get out. So I can just stand there and stomp on her all day long. Might have to get those spike shoes. I forget if, yeah, you can't damage the queen bee without spike shoes. So, let's take out this bee. Be very slow and methodical about this. Alright. Let's buy the spike shoes. Stompy, stompy. Let's see how many are left. Just a couple. I should be okay if I go down in here. Get 4 health.
Oh!
I thought I was gonna... okay, good. That worked out okay. Oh, crap. I don't have any bombs, so... man, there's not been a single shopkeeper selling bombs. Well, except at the beginning, I guess, when I bought the gloves, because I couldn't afford the bomb crate. Oh, that's kicking me in the ass. Oh, maybe there's a crate somewhere on this level. Oh, Jesus, you gotta be kidding me. Is there no way out of here? There's no... well... I can teleport out. Aw, man. That's, I really don't like how this run is going. Yeah, the teleporter is the only way I can get out of here. That is funny. I'm not seeing any bomb crate anywhere either. Well, actually... alright. Now I just have to not get killed by the ghost. Or the teleporter. Oh, Jesus. Remember when I said never bet on the teleporter? That might not end up being accurate for this run. Alright. Where the heck is... I only have 3 bombs. So I have to make them count. I actually don't really know. Oh. Oh, thank God. Okay. What's the benefit of clearing the beehive? Any loot there? No loot, but if you kill the queen bee, she drops an item that gives you 4 health immediately. The sequel is called Hotline Miami 2 Wrong Number. If it were me, I'd call it Hotline Miami 4 Wrong Number, says CPC Gamer. That's pretty good. Alright, I'm going to set this teleporter down and never touch it again. Because it's a miracle that I did not kill myself trying to do that. Alright, let's buy some bombs. Get my stocks back up. Let's bomb here and here. And I'll probably spend the remainder of my money getting a kiss from this dog, since that's the only thing you can't steal. Dude, this is creepy. That's a pretty good reward, yeah, definitely. Like, I used to be afraid of the bees, because they can be pretty, their flight pattern can be pretty erratic, but, once I got used to dealing with them, I actually like getting a bee level, because the 4 health is, it's worth having to deal with them. Okay. Should be safe. As long as I cling to this wall up here. Let's go down. Oh god. Oh, that probably would have killed me if I did not have that parachute. Alright, this is the hardest part of bombing the black, of clearing the black market, is dealing with that guy. But luckily, I did not just blow myself up there. Alright, those guys sound like they're having a good old time down there. Yeah, look at that. Duke it out, you two. No! Stupid caveman was blocking my shotgun shells. There we go. Alright, I have 16 bombs and no ropes. Which, having no ropes isn't that big of a deal if you have climbing gloves. But I would still feel better if I had some ropes. And pitching gloves. Meh. Well, I do like having pitching gloves. They're not the, they're not the most useful item you can find in a crate, but, But the government sure as hell isn't gonna tell you about it. Get it? He said duke it out. Yes. Totally intentional. Oh, fuck you! Remember what I said about a dark level totally fucking up a good run? That might be the case here. Because I can't bring the shotgun with me. Unless I don't want to bring the torch. Which means dealing with the angry shopkeeper. Jesus, look at all those. Oh yeah, pitching gloves. Alright, well. Fucking dark levels. I swear to God. Okay, well. This will be an Olmec run then. Which is actually good for me, because it means I actually have a chance of winning. And not losing 10 Spelunky bucks. Oh god, where did that torch go? Alright. No! Okay. That was close. But I'm still technically alive. Somehow. I had all that health, too. Fuck you, frog. Fuck. I should have just bombed that guy. I didn't want to waste the bomb. Too late now, since I already took 2 damage. What happens if you run out of money? I don't actually know. It hasn't come up for me yet. So, if you do lose all your money betting, make sure you let me know what happens. Well, it should be a while, since the most you can bet on... Oh, yeah. Well, hope one of you bet on Shopkeeper again. Kostra did, congratulations. Lunchbot did. Whoa. How did Lunchbot bet so much money? It says he bet 234. But McGack too bet on Shopkeeper as well, so congratulations to all of you. That's turning out to be a pretty good bet. Alright, well, that could have gone better. Hello to all the new viewers in the chat room. Make sure you go to dukeofthebomb.com/bet if you want to join the... enjoying the gambling. But of course it's not real gambling, it's just fake gambling. But as it turns out, fake gambling can be just as addictive as real gambling, as Salty Bet has proven for me. Well, that was a pretty good run until I got the goddamn dark level. Dark levels, fuck, are my bane. Stand up. There we go. So you get double of what you bet, or you get all the other bettors' bets. I'm not sure exactly how much it is. I know it's based on, like, the more people bet on a thing, the less money you get if that ends up being the cause of death. So, like, for the shopkeeper, since three of you actually bet on that, there's, you get less money for that being the cause of death, I think. And I'm not exactly sure how much it is. I think it's if you're the only person to bet on the cause of death or the victory, I guess, then I think it's 16 times whatever you bet. Because I bet 10 one time and nobody else bet for the thing I bet for, and I got 160 Spelunky bucks out of it. But I'm not sure how that's affected by how many other people bet on a thing. I imagine if there were a ton of people betting, then, I don't know how I didn't get hit there. If there are a ton of people betting, then that alters the dynamic of the bets a lot. Because, you know, if there are like 50 people watching the stream, and 49 of them bet on Shopkeeper, then the one guy who doesn't bet on Shopkeeper is going to make out like a bandit. If that's what kills me. And Salty Bet, it's a share of the other team's money. Yeah, that makes sense. But in Salty Bet, there are only two potential options you can bet on. There's, you know, CPU 1 or CPU 2. Whereas in Spelunky Roulette, there's a billion things you could potentially bet on. So yeah, it doesn't work exactly like Salty Bet, probably. Yeah, I don't know the exact math involved. That info might be at the main site for Spelunky Roulette. I didn't really look into it. Well, I have 19 bombs. I should probably get some health. That thing's been triggered, right? Yeah. That's the thing that hit me from across the screen. Oh yeah, no sticky bombs. Dope! I had this problem with forgetting that I no longer have good items when I start a new run. Oh crap, the chest is over here anyway. I'm glad I came over here. Damn it! I just wasted 4 bombs and something that should have taken 2. Haven't had many chances to sacrifice in this playthrough. Seen a few altars, but no easy sacrifices. Of course, I've taken so much damage in these runs that I'm mostly having to go. Oh crap! There's an altar right there. Oh well. I'm mostly having to go for the health. All right, watch it die. Here comes a ghost. Which side? I think it's going to be the left. No, maybe not. That's surprising. All right, let's get out of here. It says here, 464 paid out to Lunchbot. Oh, okay. 464 is the total. Yeah, I don't know how Lunchbot bets so much. I thought he could only bet 5 times whatever the base value is. And the base value is 10. Maybe there's some exploit or something that I'm not aware of. I mean, theoretically, it would be really easy to game the system, because all you would have to do is start a bunch of bets, bet everything, and just say you won every time. So, you know, it would be really, really easy to put yourself in the you know, in the top 100 or whatever. But, you know, when people do that, it makes it not fun for anyone else, so hopefully nobody does that. I guess they could be watching, you know, to see if there are any anomalies where someone wins 10 times in a row, and, you know, that's probably not going to be legitimate, so they might have anti-cheating measures in effect. Good. Glasses. Most useless item I could possibly get from a sacrifice. Because, I mean, all they do is what the Wajidai already does, so not happy with that. But, oh well, I'm one step closer to getting the cup, which would be a huge boon for me. I love this track. So chill and atmospheric. Oh, hey, Nixel. Is it possible to ban people from playing? I don't know. I didn't see anything like that. I mean, I guess it would be possible, like, for the administrators of the website, but I don't think I personally can ban people from playing in my stream. Yeah, I'm done here. Well, let's see what's over here, I guess. Just some money. Nothing special. Yeah. Under the chat window for me, it shows a shopkeeper spice and 3 empty boxes because I didn't bet yet. Oh, okay. So under the chat window, it shows you what your current bets are. So yeah, you can only bet on 5 things per game. But, I mean, you could bet, like, you could put all 5 of your bets towards spikes. Like, if you really, really have a feeling that I'm going to die to spikes, and the payout will presumably be much higher. But yeah, I don't know how Lunchbot bet so much money. But hey, I mean, I guess more power to him since he got it right. Great. I mean, the only way you can, he did it again. He bet 411 on the shopkeeper. Congratulations to Nixel, Umbreon, and Kostya, who bet on the arrow trap. Yeah, I guess it's going to be kind of a spoiler, because the stream is like a minute behind reality, so when the bets become locked, you know I'm going to die in about a minute or so. I don't really know a way around that. Can't wait until Twitch gets Chromecast support. In the meantime, I shall continue to regret getting that instead of, say, a Roku. Yeah, I've heard good things about the Chromecast. I mean, my computer is just connected to my TV, so I don't need any of those fancy schmancy stream box things. But yeah, I've heard mixed things about the Chromecast. But I guess it's so cheap, it's kind of expected. That's not going to be great. And a shitload of money up here. That is a good use of a rope. And it's bombs. I'll always trade a rope for some bombs. Duke, you should lock the bets so people don't cheat. Well, I mean, the only way to cheat, because I lock the bets as soon as I die, but, you know, since there's such a delay in the stream, I mean, you're not going to be able to see what kills me and then bet. because the bets are already going to be locked by that point. So, should be okay. I think what I'm going to start doing is locking the bets at the end of the mines. So, so at the very least, you know, there won't be any spoilers. I know it's kind of dumb to worry about spoilers in a game like this, but it does kind of take away from the fun, you know, if you know I'm about to die. Alright, so here's what we're going to do. Ah, crap, I should have dropped that pot down there. Oh well. I'll just drop that crate down there instead. Yeah, there's a huge delay. It's like a minute, so, so yeah, cheating is not really a factor. Oh, okay, good. Ooh, that is a nice box find. It's the second time I've found gloves in a crate so far during the stream. Alright, haven't seen any signs of the chest or the key so far. I'll buy some of this stuff though. I'll buy that and that and that. Why not? Oh wait, do I not have enough for that? I guess not. Okay. Oh wait, no, I got it. Ah, it's the best thing you can possibly find in a mystery box. See, by not having to worry about money, I can afford to blow some of it on mystery boxes now. And sometimes it pays off. Alright, let's explore a little bit just to make absolutely sure that the key or the eye is not on this level. I don't think it is. Oh, fudge. Dumb mistake, Duke. Dumb mistake. Oh well. At least I'm getting a health back on this level. I love the jetpack so much. Oh, it's this track again. Oh, I'm not gonna complain. Yeah, this album's only an hour long, so there's bound to be repeats and stuff. I might listen to some other game soundtracks and stuff in the future, since those are not likely to be to be flagged by YouTube. Although there have been some instances of music in VVVVVV getting flagged by people who don't even own it. That is a nice crate. So I don't know. We'll see how YouTube reacts when I post this video. Like I said, I might have to start looking for Jesus. Wow, I am very happy with this run so far. I might have to start looking for non-YouTube solutions. Because, I mean, if I'm streaming this a lot, I don't want it to be the same music every time. Because, you know, that's when it gets boring. Oh, there's the chest. Great. Alright, let's take care of you. Oh, Jesus! Okay, well, I guess she'll be able to take one hit. Oh no, didn't even have to worry about it. Great, okay. Yeah, it's really a shame how YouTube is handling this content ID stuff. Because, from my perspective, playing music during a live stream like this should absolutely be fair use. I mean, let's say I wasn't listening to something that was being given away for free. Let's say I was listening to Metallica. The only way Metallica would have a valid copyright claim that it's not fair use is if they are somehow losing money from me using their music. If people are not buying their album because they can hear the music in my stream instead. And I don't know about you, but I would not want to listen to a Metallica album with somebody like me jabbering over it the whole time. That would not be an acceptable substitute for actually buying the album, at least in my view. But you know, life doesn't always work that way. But at least if it's not hosted on YouTube, then the company would actually have to make a DMCA claim against me if they dispute my use of the music. Whereas with YouTube, you know, there's no DMCA claim involved unless I appeal the takedown. Which, that process is so arcane and complicated on YouTube that most people probably are not going to do that. Wait. Oh, there it is. I was like, what the heck was in that crate? So yeah, I might start hosting stuff on Google Drive if YouTube won't let me upload it. I mean, it would suck not having the exposure that YouTube offers, but I don't know. I don't really get that many random drive-by views anyway, so it wouldn't be a huge loss. I do pay for web hosting, but it's not enough to the web host I use. It would not be economical for me to host a large quantity of content on there. It's only for I basically just host some text files on there or some HTML files. I think they scatter shot and hope the channel owner doesn't notice before the deadline. Yeah, I'm absolutely sure that they do that. I mean, there are companies that make totally bogus copyright claims, just hoping something sticks, hoping that they can get a little bit of ad revenue from it. I would be happy to let YouTube put a link in the description to sell the MP3 of the song in my video, actually, but they don't offer that. Yeah, that's true. You would think that would make the copyright owners happy. I mean, the way I see it, using music in a video like this, it serves the same purpose that that radio and music videos serve. It's exposure for the artists. There's no reason they should object to that. Now, if somebody just uploads an entire album to YouTube, which people do, and sometimes the copyright holders allow it, which is pretty cool. But I could actually see a case for that costing the content owners money, because someone probably would go to YouTube and just play the album there instead of buying it. I know I've done that. And yeah, that is an absolutely legitimate copyright claim. But me putting background music in a video while I play a video game and talk, that's not... It's not a substitute for listening to the album. By the way, if you like the music that I'm playing, then I recommend going to DJ Roswell's Bandcamp page and buying the album there. It's pay what you want, so you can get it for nothing. But send a little money his way. It's good stuff. I didn't see a ding. I probably should have explored that level a little more thoroughly. But I think I'm okay. people or companies that really, really, really do not need the money the content ID match is producing. Yeah, absolutely. Monetize my videos. Get, you know, 25 cents for me using your song. Which, you know, I don't make money off my videos anyway, so that wouldn't bother me. But, it kind of sucks to have ads in my videos that I don't want there. I am partnered with someone, and I considered monetizing my videos and putting ads up, but I hate ads, and it would not be enough money to really make a significant impact on my life. It would be like a few bucks a month, so I decided not to do that. Oh God. I was hoping the black market entrance would be apparent soon in this level. It's always nice when the black market entrance is right at the beginning of a dark level, so you can just skip the damn dark level, more or less. Alright, I did not see nor hear a ding. So, I'm assuming the black market entrance is not on this level either. Man, I didn't see the damsel. There's a kissing booth in this level, wasn't there? Or was that the last level? Because I could sacrifice another damsel and get the cup. Oh, there it is. Okay. I should still be doing pretty okay on time. Yes. All right. I'm satisfied that the black market is not on this level, so I'm out of here. All right. See you later, CPC Gamer. Thanks for showing up. I know it's super late where you are. I'm sorry I don't stream earlier, but thanks for coming out. Actually, I had a Norwegian company claim the copyright of the Saints Row title screen music. I tried to contact the actual songwriter to encourage him to file a claim so I could acknowledge his and let him get some pennies from the 13 views the video gets. Yeah. I mean, that's really the problem with Content ID, is that any company can make a claim on any video they want without any kind of proof that they own the rights to it. So it's a really broken system. And the brokenness of the system has been more apparent recently, now that YouTube's been, or I guess it's companies being more aggressive about that kind of thing. I really hope I didn't miss the black market. That would be a real, real kick in the shins. I usually use Adblock on my YouTube browsing anyway. Does anyone know a way to unblock it per uploader? You can, not per uploader, I don't think. You can whitelist a specific page with Adblock. But, I guess in YouTube's case, you'd have to whitelist every single video you want, you don't want to run Adblock on. I run Adblock except for sites that I know need the ad revenue, which I guess technically, I mean, Google makes all their money from ads, so they technically do need the money. But I think Adblock users are a small enough percentage of their market share that there it is. I guess that's hypocritical of me, actually. I shouldn't run Adblock on any site. Except sites that use, like, annoying flash ads and ads with sound and stuff like that.
Media around the world reported Satan in the suburbs of New York City. It's a typical summer night in a typical American suburb.
Trying not to piss the shopkeepers off prematurely. But these frogs are not making my life easy. Alright, that shouldn't piss them off.
But what began as a party quickly turned into a nightmare.
If someone was going to run ads and get money for my videos, I'd rather be the right person than some random LLC out of a dude's garage. Yeah, absolutely. I mean, I'm fine with ads, you know, if they're supporting somebody directly. But, you know, supporting a giant corporation is not high on my list of priorities. Alright, let's open this up a little bit more. And then I'll be ready to get the shopkeeper party started. Adblock Plus has acceptable ads thingy. Yeah, that's true. Adblock Plus does give you some options there. What's LLC? A limited liability company. It's a type of business that someone can register for in the U.S. Well, I guess you can have an international LLC as well. Supposedly, if you're just starting a small business, an LLC is the best. Oh, God! Oh, Jesus Christ. Oh, my God. Shopkeeper's getting feisty. He shouldn't be able to jump that high. Okay, well, he's definitely trapped down in there now. Oh, come on. Had the decency to just die already. That was a very, very close call. Actually, that was two close calls. Oh, God, already? Oh, that's the thing about the black market levels. Alright. Oh, fuck. Gotta get out of here. Alright, let's get the ghost out of the way. I would like to rescue you, but I would much rather bring the shotgun with me at this point. I mean, I do have the cup, so as soon as I'm out of the black market, I should be able to start farming some enemies for health and build my health back up a little bit. God, all these tiki traps. Oh crap, you can't unbet. Yeah, that's true. Once you place a bet, you're locked into it. Hey, just drop, what's going on? There's a company that claims money off of birdsong. Not sure what birdsong is. You mean like actual recordings of birdsongs? Like videos of birds singing? Cause that's actually pretty funny. Yes, we own the intellectual property of these naturally occurring animals. Yeah, that belongs to us. Birds are a registered trademark of Disney. Have you ever seen Snow White? You think those are just generic birds? Alright, hopefully that shopkeeper fell to his death. Looks like he did. Ooh, wow! Jesus Christ. I am just spoiled for bombs this run. 78, Jesus. That actually might be enough for a hell run. Alright, I did not see a Moai head on this level. Let me look around a little bit just to make absolutely sure. Moai head usually doesn't show up until 4-2 at the earliest. Alright, well. The best thing you can do with damsels once you have the cup is to hit them twice and then take them to the exit. If you want to maximize the amount of healing potential they have. I did say that killing them is the best option, but this way I actually get a lot of blood for the cup. Not a full heart's worth, but most of a full heart's worth. And I get the heart for actually rescuing the damsel. And I feel better about myself. For not being a ruthless, cold-blooded murderer. Be right back, copywriting the sound of rain. Aw, man. I think their logic is that you're paying for the medium, not the content. Yeah, but, I mean, the medium is owned by YouTube. And YouTube, you know, if you're just if you upload just a video that you record of, like, nature or your friends or something, YouTube, they don't need to put ads on that because, you know, they have, Google has enough money as it is. They, you know, I mean, they buy bandwidth in so much bulk that I'm sure, you know, they have enough to cover it. Hi, shopkeeper. Oh, hi, shopkeeper. Bye, shopkeeper. Hey, why don't you follow your buddy down there? Oh, I guess you did. Okay. Wait, is there a mullet head on the stage? Gotta double check. Do my due diligence. Aw, man, lost my parachute. Oh well. Alright, I think I'm okay. Pretty sure there's no mullet head here. Oh, I should not have gone that way. Oh well. I'm safe. What do you mean pay for water? The one that runs from the tap. Well, they purify and make it usable. You pay for that. Yeah, there's a... I mean, someone definitely has to pay for that. You know, I think that water should be... you know, a public utility, not run by private companies, and you know, taxes should pay for the purification and all that. I think having a private company, I'm not sure how we got on this tangent, but having a private company controlling the water supply is not a good idea. I mean, hell, we saw that, you know, in West Virginia. With the water crisis that we had. Oops. Didn't mean to actually kill him. Oh well. This is a good run. Glad I made it now. Oh, thank you. Yeah, I'm pretty happy with the way this run is going so far. Knock on wood. Don't jinx me. It is a good run, says Twisted Little Heart. Thank you. Oh, and welcome to the chat room, Twisted Little Heart. I did not give you a proper shout out. Actually, I should have just rescued that damsel, so I have 5 hearts going into the next level, since I'm about to lose all before my health anyway. And I'm about to lose my shotgun. That sucks. Whee! Oh wow, that actually doesn't hurt you when you ride the falling platform all the way down. Unless you fall off the world, of course. Jesus Christ, I have a lot of bombs. Okay. There are places that need pure water that don't have it, and yet they still have to pay for it, i.e. bottled water. Yeah, that's a shame. That there are still places in the world that don't have access to clean water. I mean, I guess I really shouldn't complain that I wasn't able to use the water for, you know, 5 days, because there's still places in the world that don't have clean water at all. You know, first world problems, I guess. All right, let's, I was going to say let's take care of that UFO, but he seems to be off doing his own thing now. Man, you suck. You probably just killed... Nope, he's still alive. Okay, good. Ah! See if I can make a nice little pit for him to fall into. There we go. Oh, crap. Did that fall hurt me? I don't think so. I don't know. Oh, well. You have every right to complain. In fact, it'd be unconstitutional if you didn't. Oh, yeah, I know. I have the legal right to complain. But, you know, there are people in the world who definitely have it worse than I do. Oh, that didn't kill the... Wow. I didn't know the alligator dude could survive a bomb blast. Fuck. Supposedly, there's some way to farm these things that this guy spits out and get, like, a shitload of health if you have the cup. But I don't know how to do it. If anyone in the chat room knows, then let me know. Because that would be helpful if I could just farm those things forever and get 99 health. Which is, supposedly... No! Fuck. Okay. Did anyone bet on the swamp? No, nobody did. Whoa, who the hell is... Sim Call 21. I don't know. He's not in the chat room, but... Oh, yeah. I guess he is. He just showed up. Okay, well, nobody won. Sorry, guys. See, I died to... the technical name for it is a crush trap. All right, what time is it? 8:38? Okay. I guess I will get started on the daily challenge. Hit them before they hit you, says Just Rob. Well, I tried that, but they didn't seem to drop blood when I hit them with my whip. Oh, semicolon 21. Yeah, I guess that makes sense. Well, welcome. Always good to see a new face in the chat room. Let me first say that this is privileged information. When the tape is over... Somebody tweeted something yesterday saying that the daily challenge was the same as the previous days. There was like some kind of glitch. I hope it's not still affected. I didn't notice if it was the same. I'm pretty sure it was not the same when I played it again. But, or when I did yesterday's daily challenge, it wasn't the same as the days before that. So, my strategy for the daily challenge was just try to beat Olmec without buying anything, without spending any money. But, now that I'm pretty confident in my ability to do it with shopkeepers, I'm probably going to do the same strategy as my other runs, my normal runs, and try to make it to the City of Gold and get a shitload of money that way, which probably will not end with me actually winning the game, but it might let me win the daily challenge, or not win, but you know, beat my friends in the daily challenge, because you know, beating your friends is what it's all about. First stream I've watched, actually. Wow. Well, don't let my stream be an indication of the quality of other Spelunky streams. Because there are a lot of people out there who are actually quite good at this game, who do streams. Check out Bananasaurus Rex if you haven't seen his stuff before. That dude is like a Spelunky savant. I don't know how he does it. some sort of superhero. The one thing I will pay for, even during the daily challenge, is bombs. Because if I can make it to the City of Gold, then theoretically the bombs will, you know, pay for themselves and then some. I think that's the third time this track has come up. The one I'm not too terribly fond of. They say we got about 25 years of good water left before we got to think of something. Death sounds like a viable and deserved option to me, so just drop. Ah, crap. Apologies for my my grunt there. I grunt a lot when I play this game. You know, it's like tennis. Grunting helps you play better. Any bombs? Bomb bag. I guess I might as well pick that up. You know, I won't spend... I won't buy, like, tons of bombs. But it is good to buy at least some bombs. Especially if you don't find any during a playthrough. Hi, Snake. Oh, if this wasn't a daily challenge, I would probably buy that mystery box. Just in case it's a jetpack. Actually doing pretty good on money so far. Did he just kiss the skull you were holding? Yeah, probably. I mean... You know, who knows how long they've been trapped down here. Their senses of, like, social decency are probably, you know, all shot to hell. You know, having been trapped in mines for X number of days, hours. Ah, crap. Stupid fucking scorpion. Okay, let's take a small risk here. Probably not a good idea to take a risk in a daily challenge, but, why the hell not? I mean, I'm going to piss the shopkeepers off eventually anyway. Alright. Okay, nobody got mad at me. That's good. Alright, let's see if I can blow that thing up without killing myself. Damn it. Damn it. Damn it! Phew! Ah, it's just a parachute. Damn it. Oh well. Okay, it's the Leonard Nimoy... rat mash up again. Probably not Leonard Nimoy, but close enough. Oh crap. I thought the key came down with the idol. Oh well. How do they get past the monsters anyway? The damsels? Good question. Hey, there's a parachute just randomly buried in the mines there. That damsel's worth going for. Oh, crap. Alright. Get the hell out of here. Would have liked to bring that skull with me, but oh well. Alright, end of the mines is coming up here, so if you don't have your bets in, go on ahead and get them in, because I'm going to lock the bets. Remember, I am going to piss the shopkeepers off, so it might be a good bet. Or, you know, spikes, always a popular choice. I was kind of hoping to get to hell during the stream, but it doesn't look like it's going to happen. I've only gotten there once. And it shouldn't be repeating this much. I mean, there's an hour's worth of tracks in this playlist. So it should repeat every song twice, theoretically. If the randomization is perfect. Which, of course, you know, no computerized randomization is perfect. Better question, how is it not dark in these caves? This game is so unrealistic. Well, it is dark in some of the caves. Alright, hope you guys have your bets in, because they are now locked. If any of you don't have your bets in, then, you know, complain, and I can unlock them and let you bet. But you really should have bet by now, if you're going to. Nice. Alright, looks like I might actually be able to show off one of the secret levels, because I thought that the only way to get the secret level was to forgo going to the black market, but the one time I experimented with it, the secret level, actually the black market entrance was there, so you get the best of both worlds in that case. So I want to try that out. Well, assuming the black market is not in this level, which it doesn't look like it is. Ooh, altar. Is that dude selling anything worth spending money on? Probably not, no. Alright, let's use a rope here. Get some springy boots. Aw, he has a fighting chance against Shoppy. Well, why is that an all? Oh, because you bet on the shopkeeper? Alright. Pretty sure the secret level isn't here, so let's go somewhere cool. Somewhere I've never been during a stream before. Looks like the entrance in the temple level. But it's not. I know no computerized randomization is perfect, but the individual media player producers could at least make it randomized without repeats. Yeah, it would be nice if there was an option where it plays through every track. Well, actually, I think there is an option where it plays through every track in a random order. A wolf howls in the distance. Aw, I should have bounced off that thing and made it up to the top of the castle. I wonder what's actually up there. I have enough ropes. Let's see. Not much. There is a secret character up there, though. So yeah, this is the Haunted Castle level. You can only get to it by bombing underneath that one tombstone in a haunted jungle level. Oh god. Wait, that guy made it all the way down here, huh? Oh. Black Knight, the lord of the castle. He fights with supreme confidence and won't give up until death. Well. Whoa, can I pick up a shield? Fuck you, Piranha. I know if I... Whoa, that's awesome. The ultimate in protective armor. Even a cannonball couldn't get through this. Huh. Well, that is kind of cool. Oh, crap. Well, I guess I'm taking that with me instead of the shotgun. Because I forgot... Oh, there's the black market. I forgot that the castle gate closed. Alright, let's see if I can make it up and get that secret character before the ghost shows up. Should be able to, since I took out the hardest enemy in the game. Or in this level, rather. Oh, crap. I wanted to sacrifice her, but I ran past that door like a dummy. Oh, well. Ah! Bad throw. Aw, man. There's a Dracula, too. So, what do you guys think about playing my own music during these things? Yes? No? Stick with the default music? Stick with the classic music? Oh, wait. It's not a character. It's just a stupid hired hand. What the F? Well, at least I can sacrifice him. Since I did not get a chance to sacrifice the damsel. Oh, crap. Yes! Oh, fuck the shield, I'm leaving. Cannonball can't get through it, but the shotgun can. Yeah, good point. I was able to shotgun that guy to death pretty easily. Any good loot on that level? I don't think so. I thought the reward for that level was getting a secret character, but apparently that's not the case. I don't like that man trap being there. Oh, fuck. Nixon Lombrion says shrug. Supposedly about my music question. I mean, I'm probably going to play music regardless, but, you know, I'm just curious how it's being received. Oh man, I should lure those two shopkeepers to the left before I go after the Ankh. I always forget to do that. I get the first two guys, but these guys I always kind of forget about. Wish I had a shotgun. I just stand here and shoot people. Come on, fall. There you go. Okay. Oh yeah, I have gloves now. Thanks, robbery. Remember, kids, robbery, the coolest of all crimes. Aw, that didn't kill him? What? Aw, fuck. Oh, well. Oh, out of bombs. I will just pop on over here and help myself. Why are those... They shouldn't explode so quickly when I stick them to the shopkeeper. The fuse on them should not be affected by that. Oh, fuck. Well. Nothing in here, right? Okay. Oh, man. I have to go for those bombs. Shopkeeper aside. Got him. Alright. I am in good shape. I just need to lure the ghost up here. I started replaying Diablo 1. Such an awesome game. Now all I think about is loot. Yeah, Diablo 1's tough to go back to, in my opinion. After Diablo 2 and other, you know, games of that type. Going back to Diablo 1 is just, it's very slow. Fuck you, Ghost. Could he have shot the bomb? Oh, yeah. Well, I don't know. I didn't really see which part of the shopkeeper the bomb was stuck to. I guess it could have been stuck to the barrel of the shotgun. Anything's possible. Ah, Jesus. Fuck. Hate boomerang guys. Lost my shotgun too. Well, I didn't lose it, but I lost use of it temporarily. Alright, remember, Duke, there's an angry shopkeeper at the end of this level. Don't forget about that like you always do. Aw, man, he's gonna be, like, all enclosed down there, too. Aw, man, there's two of them. And there's plenty of bombs in there too. Nice. Alright. Let's take care of that guy before he becomes a problem. Whew. Man, part of me just wants to go to the exit, but, well, I have 40 bombs. Fuck it. That should be plenty. Assuming this bat doesn't kill me. Alright. I'm out. Shopkeeper's so angry, everything stuck to him has a short fuse. That's pretty good. You know, I haven't even really been thinking about picking up money. I mean, this is a daily challenge, so I guess I should still be mindful of that. Ah, that sucks. I mean, you know, normally money is not really an issue because I'm just I'm just playing for distance, not for score. Hanging on to the shotgun isn't really that important at this stage of the game, because I'm going to lose it as soon as I go into the Moai head anyway. Which should be coming up pretty shortly. Fuck! Why do I do that? Because I'm dumb, that's why. Question answered. Oh, bye, dog. $15,000 from that idol. That's pretty good. Hey, what's up, Kibitz? Haven't seen you around that much lately. Glad you can make it. If you get crushed into spikes, which does it actually count as? Yeah, like Megax said, whatever the death entry says. So it'll say, well, the only problem with that is if you die in stage whatever 4, like 4-4 or 3-4 or whatever, it won't actually say what the cause of death was. It'll say, I almost made it to the next area. So I guess I'd have to use my own judgment there. Oh, I don't have spike shoes yet. That sucks. Have to improvise. I have a little room to play around since since if I die, I'll just get resurrected inside the Moai head. That's the nice thing about this level. You can, you don't have to be super careful here. Like, I was just not careful at all dealing with that shopkeeper, but I guess it worked out. See, what would be really nice is if I could make it to the City of Gold and beat Olmec in the same playthrough. Because when you beat Olmec, the value of that giant idol is added to your score at the end of the game. And I think it might be 100,000. I'm not entirely sure about that. Oh, I'm done. Okay. Oh yeah, parachute. Oh well. Mostly asleep when you're streaming. Yeah, I know the time I stream is not great for people who don't live in the U.S., but, I would say it's the spikes that we get the frag. If I'm crushed into spikes, yeah. I agree, that would probably be what I go with. Of course, you know, it's so easy to get a chain reaction in this game where a million things are like, could be called the cause of death if you look at it a certain way. I do not like this level layout. I do not like it one bit. Oh god! This is the level layout with old Frosty there. Wow, he drops a lot of loot when you kill him. He drops ropes, a compass, and spike shoes. This shopkeeper is not going to be easy to deal with. Oh, never mind. Alright. Grab that shotgun. Oh. Grab that dog first. Kind of forgot that I have the cup. I've had some pretty good luck in these runs. But you cannot count on luck forever. I feel pretty good about the stream and all, though. All in all. I showed off a new area of the game. Well, not new, but it's new to me. The Haunted Castle. I had a couple pretty good runs. Knock on wood. I say if there's no official cause of death, you should give it out of the plausible ones to the one with the fewest number of people betting on it. What does the Golden Hat item do? That's what lets you, it lets you get into the City of Gold. You need that and you need the Scepter. And the Scepter you get by defeating Anubis in this level. I think you need the hat to get into the City of Gold. You might just need it to get into Hell. But, I mean, you need the Book of the Dead to get into Hell, which is in the City of Gold. So, either way. Whew! Alright, I see you, Anubis. I see you. Oh, God. I see you too, Alligator Man. Thanks for triggering that trap for me. Oh, maybe that's how you farm for blood. With the mummies, you just shotgun those things. But that would kill the mummy too, right? Well, don't really want to risk it during a daily challenge. All right, have to lose a shotgun, unfortunately. Okay, shopkeeper's dead. Scepter is obtained. I think I'm good to go. Oh, does it do anything else? I don't think so. I'm pretty sure the ghost still spawns when you have the hat. Blow it up from the bottom and have him fall on the altar. Yeah, it didn't occur to me. So with the scepter, it's not a good idea to use it, but if you have to use it, like, you can use it. Well, never mind. I'm losing the scepter immediately anyway. Alright. I could grab that idol. See, this trap, when you get that idol, the walls close in and spikes come down from the ceiling. So I'm going to do it this way. Because, you know, it is... Oh, wait. The idol's probably going to get destroyed by that. Yeah. Oh, well. I was going to say, it is a daily challenge run, so I should be trying for loot, but didn't work out. Oh, well. I have 38 bombs heading into the city of gold. I feel pretty good about this. Not to jinx myself, but... There's potentially a lot of money in store for me. Of course, if I am going to try for an Olmec kill, then, I don't want to use all my bombs, obviously. I don't think I'm even going to try to get the Book of the Dead, since this is a daily challenge, and I don't have much hope of beating Hell. I'd rather just get the Olmec kill, if possible, and get the money that you get for that. Since, I mean, let's face it, I don't have a chance of beating Hell. I've only been to Hell once. Oh god. Fuck you. Yeah, that trap that killed me last time. Asshole. See, every one of these bombs is giving me, like, 1,500 to 2,000 to 3,500 gold. So, buying bombs early on in a daily challenge is definitely worth it. Yeah, there's the Book of the Dead down there. If you get it, it spawns Anubis 2, which he's not hard to kill, but I'll be tempted to do a hell run or try a hell run, and I just don't want to go that route, at least not this time. Maybe when I'm better at the game, but not now. Of course, you know, I can't spend too much time farming for gold here because the ghost is still very much a threat. Oh fudge. That was almost disastrous. Shopkeeper still alive? I don't see him. I don't see his body either. Where the heck did he go? Alright, ghost is gonna come in from the right. Which means I need to, need to lure him over this direction. Still have plenty of ropes, luckily. My high score so far is 360,000. So, I might beat that in this playthrough. I don't know. I was not really paying attention to loot for a lot of this run, because I was so focused. Nobody bet on the ghost. Sorry, guys. I wish I could say the cause of that death was stupidity. But it wasn't. It was a ghost. It was just a very, very poor jump. Oh, 283,000. That is a respectable daily challenge. Number 27. That's not going to last, but it feels pretty good. Being number 27 out of 1,000. What are all these unknowns? Huh. Maybe the daily challenge thing is glitched. Did I beat anyone famous? Well, all these unknown people might be famous. I don't know what's going on with that. Some sort of weird bug. Panda Z people. I'm glad I beat that guy. Or girl. Yankee UXO. It's a good username. Alright, well, that was the daily challenge run. Sorry nobody bet on the ghost. Oh yeah, there is a Super Meat Boy character that I have not unlocked, and I don't know how to unlock. www.redeye. It's not even a proper URL. Fix your shit, man. Okay, well, anyway. I feel good about the daily challenge. I don't feel good about how I died. That was really stupid on my part. I shouldn't have pressed my luck. I got greedy. I went for more treasure than I should have tried to go for. We didn't really expect you to jump into it. Yeah, I wasn't expecting me to either. Good night, Nixel. Thanks for hanging out. If only the shopkeeper kept his rage at bay till he got down to him. Yeah. That would have been entertaining. Okay, well, thanks everyone for hanging out. Hope you had fun. I hope the death roulette adds a degree of fun to the stream that wasn't here before. And I'll see you all next time. Goodbye.